this is a hand colouring technique that can be a lot of fun. It remains fresh because each one is different. It's quite exciting because sometimes they work and sometimes they really don't. But if they work, they're wonderful. So what I've done here, I'll put that down upside down. I found an old block of lime. It's got a big crack in it, but it's a very nice piece of wood. Oh look, it's got one of rods on the back. Probably going to split in half any minute. Anyway, I printed a number of these and I did it yesterday so that the ink is dry now. Because if the ink was wet, then it would bleed. So this is dry, but I'm going to hand colour on the back. And it radiates through, as you can see here. It's different. If I'd painted it, on the front, it would have hard edges, but because I've done it on the back, you get some wonderful mottled effects, and you're never quite sure what you're going to get because it depends how much water is in the ink. One thing to watch out for is not to let it bleed outside the mark. That means not going right up to the edge there, and here I've balanced that with that, but I've moved very quickly. So it is hit and miss, but it's great fun. So here we are, I'm going to turn that over, and I've put it down on newspaper because we need an absorbent surface underneath to pick up the surplus ink. Okay, so. I use any inks that come to hand. I mean, this is a photo dye that I found in the cupboard. I don't know how it's going to perform, but I've used watercolour, I've used watered down printing ink, gouache, whatever you've got. So we'll see what happens. The other thing I'm going to try is having two colours on one brush. Create a line there, and also sometimes neat ink and sometimes watered down ink. So let's see what happens there. And I don't know how it's going to come through. It remains to be seen. Just want one more bright colour in there. Right, let's have a look. This doesn't show very well, partly because it's still bleeding through. So what I now need to do is help the ink come through to the front with some water. But I have to be careful here because some of the ink's bled, so we throw the newspaper away. I quite like it actually, as it is, but I think I'm going to bring a little bit through. So. What's happening is, because these are photo dyes, they're performing in a different way from watercolours or anything else, but I'm liking it. I think we'll say this one is virtually done. I'm going to put a tiny bit of ink on the front because there's a blob there, which I don't like. So I'm going to disguise it. Right, well, there's number one. I don't mind this spots. Big moment. Careful not to put that down on the wet. Ooh, right. You can always add colour to the front as well. Might try that a little bit. So it's where painting and printmaking meet, really. For those printmakers who used to be painters.